Did the Wright brothers invented the first airplane? The Wright brothers, their contribution on aviation and airplane. Humans had been fascinated with the sky and were dreaming of joining the birds flying in the sky. Early flies were essentially attempts to mimic birds' flight. Designs were primitive and impractical, but over time, they became more complex. The Wright brothers were American aviation pioneers generally credited with inventing, building, and flying the world's first successful motor-operated airplane. The brothers were two among the seven Wright children. Both of them went to high school but neither received a diploma. Orville Wright left high school in his third year in 1889 and decided to venture into the printing business. With the help of Wilbur Wright, Orville designed and built his own printing machine. Wilbur joined Orville in the printing business, and he was named as the editor and Orville was the publisher. In December 1892, the brothers opened a bicycle sales and repair shop. In the year 1896, they started their bicycles making business. The first kite was invented in China during 1000 BC. During the 800 AD, a boss Bin Furnas, among other who was trying to fly with curious experiments which he made. As time passed by, Leonardo da Vinci designed flying machines in the late 15th century. In May 1896, Samuel Langley flew an unmanned fixed-wing model aircraft powered by steam. In the mid of the same year, Octave Chanute, a Chicago engineer, gathered several men to test different types of gliders over the dunes along Lake Michigan's shores. One of the most influential aviators of the time was German Otto Lilienthal, who successfully completed multiple glider flights, more than 2,500, from hills around the region in Germany. Lilienthal studied birds and examined their flight to determine the aerodynamics involved. He was a prolific inventor who designed many models of aircraft, including biplanes, those with two wings, one above the other, and monoplanes. Tragically, Lilienthal came to an untimely death 5 years after his first flight. He broke his neck in a glider crash, but at the time, this incident sparked the Wright brothers' interest in flight research. In 1899, Wilbur requested for publications and information on aeronautics from the Smithsonian Institution. The brothers started their mechanical and aeronautical experiments. They based their experiments on the works of Chanute, Sir George Cayley, Lilienthal, Langley, and Leonardo da Vinci. Orville and Wilbur Wright struggled to produce a craft that would be light and powerful enough to achieve their objective, so they engaged with French automobile engineers, but their lightest car engines were still too heavy. To find a solution, the brothers, who ran a bicycle repair shop in Dayton, Ohio, decided to build their own engine with the help of their friend, mechanic Charles Taylor. Their aircraft, aptly named the Flyer, was a wood and fabric biplane 12.3 meters, approximately 40 feet, in length and with a wing area of 47.4 square meters, 155 square feet. It had a cable system that enabled the pilot to control the height of the wings and tail, which enabled the pilot to control both the plane's elevation and lateral movement. The Wright brothers worked on several different gliders over the years, and most of their first models did not have an engine. Their first glider with an engine was built in 1903. The Wright brothers took their first successful flight on this powered glider on December 17, 1903. Orville made the first flight, and Wilbur took the second. The Wright brothers continued to develop their aircraft and a year later conducted the first circular flight of an engine-powered airplane. Further tweaking ensued, and in 1905, the Flyer 3 was far more dependable than its two previous incarnations, offering reliable performance and maneuverability. The brothers invented the three-axis control, which lets the pilot maintain equilibrium while steering the aircraft. The Wright brothers patented their invention on May 22, 1906. This method is used up to date on all types of fixed-wing aircrafts. Both Wilbur and Orville were lifelong bachelors. Wilbur gradually became occupied with business matters for the Wright Company. Wilbur spent the next year before his death traveling, where he spent a full 6 months in Europe attending to various business and legal matters. After returning to Dayton in early May 1912, worn down in mind and body, he fell ill again and was diagnosed with typhoid fever. Wilbur died, at age 45, at the Wright family home on May 30. Orville succeeded to the presidency of the Wright Company upon Wilbur's death. Orville died at age 76 on January 30, 1948, following his second heart attack. The history of the airplane is a tale of many miraculous technical advances occurring in a relatively short period. We must never forget how truly remarkable it is that we as humans have found the ability to fly. Thank you for watching, and please don't forget to like and subscribe and hit the notification button.